Hey there everybody, it's Mark Crilly. I'm back with another How to Draw video. Today we're going to be learning how to draw the head and face in profile, and then the head as it is turning away from us. Now I've got two perfect squares here. The measurements happen to be 2 inches on all sides. That comes out to around 5 centimeters, but as I always say, you can make it any size you want as long as it's just a perfect square. Now I've also put kind of crosshairs in here that divide it into perfect quadrants. Sounds like I'm in a science fiction movie. I'm from the Gamma Quadrant. In any case, we're going to go ahead and start drawing some basic guidelines for this head here, which, as I said, is going to be in profile. All right, so you see this line is pretty much a perfect circle as it comes across here, connecting these 2 points. And then as it comes over here, there's a little bit of an angle as it comes down into the forehead, which gets quite straight. And then just a short little line that cuts back, creating the sort of underside of the brow there. Well, let's continue working on the contours of this head. All right, so this one, hopefully not too tricky, begins to curve back in, but then it stops and goes quite straight for the back of the neck, and just below the square, it begins to curve back out to the shoulders. I'm not going to spend too much time drawing the shoulders in this video, but I thought I'd get at least a little indication of them here. Now, what I want to do is add one more guideline that's going to divide these bottom squares pretty neatly in half. Okay, so you can see it's pretty much right between those 2 lines, maybe just a little touch closer to this center line than to the lower one. This one is going to help us figure out where to draw the nose, and then also for placing the ears. In fact, why don't I go ahead and draw the line for the ear right now. All right, so you can see the ear is just a little to the left of this line, and then just a little higher up from this cross line that we just drew. And yeah, that's just basically the guidelines for getting it in the right spot. Notice this little area up here, that ends up being about 1/3, maybe a little less than 1/3 of the entire ear. So now it's time to get that all-important line of the nose in place. Now, I always find that drawing the angle of this line is quite tricky, figuring out just exactly what kind of an angle it is. As you can see, maybe by looking at the little triangle that's formed here, you know, it's a little more up and down than it is side to side. But basically, if you figure that you're trying to hit this line right there and you have just a little space there to curve back, all of that together can hopefully help you get that line in the right place. Now before we go on to drawing really the trickiest parts, which for me would be the mouth and the chin, I want to put in one very important guideline that's going to really you know, help a lot in terms of getting all those lines in the right place. So you can see I've put a line in here that is kind of creating a similar triangle, just sort of flipped upside down from the one that we had before. That's running from the tip of the nose right down to here, and that is where indeed the tip of the chin is going to rest. So I'm going to go ahead and get those lines in for the chin, maybe also drawing the line of the neck. So you see I've taken this point where the triangle meets this lower line, and just going a tiny bit up from there, I create almost a sort of a 90 degree angle right here coming down to the neck. Now, you do have to pay attention to this distance here from the tip of the chin to where the neck joins the jaw, and I would say that that's maybe just a little over 1/3, right, of that distance there. It kind of neatly breaks into thirds, actually, which is convenient. And then, so like I said, a 90 degree angle, there's a bit, for a male, human male, he is human, I hope. Not an alien being. For a male, you are going to have an indication of the Adam's apple here, and then coming down and rejoining the upper chest area. One thing I just want to point out is that, you know, having this angle of this line like as it is here really is suggestive of youth, right? And as you get older, this line begins to drop down a little. So yeah, he certainly seems to be fit and in very good shape. Well, before we get on to, as I said, the trickiest part here, which is the chin, the lips, and so forth, let's do something that's a little less intensive in terms of requiring focus. I'm going to get an extra line in here for the jaw itself. Now, this is kind of an illusion here in the sense that, you know, people don't have a line like this across their face. Really, what you're doing is adding a line to suggest where shading would go, and helpful in illustrations sometimes to include to exaggerate things just a touch so that we see the structure. Anyway, you do want this to come, actually I'm going to erase this a little bit, you want this to come over here, and then it begins to curve rather sharply up to meet the ear. But as I said, this is sort of a false line, a line that doesn't really exist, to the degree where I'm basically going to erase things away here and not have that, not have the ear actually join in. You know, in a very cartoony drawing, you might just continue that line, but I'm going for something a little closer to realistic, you know, drawing techniques here on this video. So anyway, I'm leaving a little gap there between those two. Well, it is time to place the eye. I think that's the next thing we can do before we start getting into drawing the lips. Okay, so as you can see, it's really just like a little letter V. And the key thing is to get the distance between this line and the beginning of this, which is really the eyelash line, I should point out here. In fact, I'll probably just add right now. I'll go ahead and draw this right in here. This is the upper eyelid. We see a little indication of that just above that line. And I found in the photo reference that I looked at that it was really the eyelash line that was lining up with that exact halfway point between, you know, from the square that we drew to begin with. I'll go ahead and draw a little bit of a the iris of the eye here. And why don't we, while we're at it, why not throw caution to the wind? You only live once. Let's draw an eyebrow. Doggone it. And I'm going to come in here and I guess this line should not, the line of the eyebrow should not actually touch this line of the forehead, but it gets awfully close from this angle. So there you go. You can see I've been actually sort of putting off the inevitable this time of drawing the lips. Yeah, indeed, it is. It's a tricky thing to do, I guess I'll, without a safety net, just go in here and start drawing it. So let's begin by drawing an indication of the nostril. Just a little bit of a line here. I always encourage people to not go overboard in terms of indicating the nostril. It can very quickly look sort of pig-nosed or just call too much attention to itself. And in terms of drawing the lips, I would like to begin with the chin. I feel a little more sure of myself down here than I do going straight into that upper lip area. Any of you who have tried to draw the face in profile, I think you'll agree that the lips create the biggest challenge in terms of them looking sort of puckered when you don't really want them to look puckered. So anyway, I'm curving this, I'm doing a sort of a curving line for the chin, then kind of a straightish line. Now, we put in that initial sort of triangle shaped diagonal line. The lips should never actually quite touch that line, though they do come close. And basically what you want to do is try to get the placement of the actual line of the mouth to be a touch closer to the nose than it is to the chin. Go ahead and put this in here. I may need to adjust things. I tend to like to have this line sloping down just a little, this line of the mouth itself. Then kind of curving up here. And it can indeed, as I said, be a bit of a trick to not have the appearance of a puckered mouth. What you're really trying to go for is a mouth that is at rest, you know, that is calm, relaxed, taking it easy. And I think this is good enough. What do you think? But you could hear in my voice my nervousness as I try to draw the lips in profile. It really is a challenging thing. So if you have troubles with it, I hear you. I have troubles with it too. Now I have a whole separate video that's on drawing the ear. I will link to it, drop in a annotation link right here, but then also in the info box below if you want a lesson on drawing the ear. For now though, I'm going to draw all of that stuff in time-lapse. All right, well, that kind of gets us to the basics of what we need for this drawing. I suppose we can get one more line in here along the neck that sort of suggests some of the musculature there. Notice the where it begins here at the base of the Adam's apple, and then at a very slight angle begins to head up towards toward the ear. And then otherwise, sometimes I may get indicate just a little bit of shading here for the nose. I think it can kind of help. You don't, again, you don't want to go overboard, but I think it can help to have a little bit of shading. And I don't want this one to be about the hair. Sorry, guys. I have to sort of pick and choose in terms of what the subject matter of the video is going to be. And this time, it's so much on facial feature placement, there's just no time for teaching how to draw the hair. So I'm going to go ahead and do all that in time lapse. All right, well, I'm going to add more detail to this later, but I guess I could point out just a few things. The hair generally does have some volume to it, so the contour of the hair is going to be higher than that of the actual scalp. And interesting, I always find how for men, it doesn't seem to happen for women, this sort of area of the sideburns, but I guess it depends on hairstyles. I can't really see, but it's always been interesting to me how the hair tends to begin to move almost at an angle, you know, as it's coming in towards the forehead, and then goes up just a little bit, and then you'd get that sort of line of the upper forehead. And so you see this little shape here again and again on... Well, I don't want to say all different men, but most men's hair seems to be sort of growing in a pattern like that. Then also notice that the lower, at the back of the neck, where the hair begins to grow, is really beginning just a touch above that first line that we had there. Well, now it's time to move on to drawing really the thing that interested me most about doing this video, and that is to draw someone who's facing away from us. Quite a challenging thing to draw, and if you do comics, if you do manga, you may find that it is a useful pose to be able to draw. I can talk a little more about that later, but let's go ahead and get some of the basic guidelines in place. All right, well, the first thing you're going to notice is that this line, instead of beginning over here near the square, is beginning in quite a bit, probably, what is that? A little less than one-third of that space from here to there. That's because the head, as it turns in space, just takes up a little less, I mean, there's a little less distance from the front to the back as compared to when you are in true profile. But otherwise, it's kind of following the similar shape, as you might expect. And just notice, though, that the space between this line and the forehead line is compressed quite a bit compared to over there. Again, just owing to what happens to the contours of the face as someone begins to turn away from you. Let's do as we did before. Go ahead and get the back of the neck in place. Okay, so I decided for this one to do a little more of an indication of the shoulder here. And when we come over here, we'll draw the rest of it. But basically, just notice again, it's following a pretty similar shape to what it did before. In fact, if we were to sort of jump in here and add a line across the back of the head here, I would say that the relationship of this line to that new line is pretty close to what we have there. So interestingly, even as it turns in space, you get a similar contour here on the back of the head. It's a little different order from what we did before, but I want to go ahead and draw the ear before I go on to the next stuff. Now, one of the trickiest things about drawing someone's face and head as they turn away from you is what happens to the ear, because the you know, the shape of the ear causes it to really do unusual things as the face turns away from it. Makes it sound like the ear is doing his ear is doing unusual things. Oh my goodness, we better get this on video. But anyway, it you basically are seeing it from an odd angle that doesn't really allow you to see the full you know, details of I guess what you would call the front or the side of the ear. You're really going back behind it, and what I end up doing is creating a sort of an S shape that is just for the sort of rim of flesh that follows around the edge of the ear, and then it becomes quite important to get some indication of this sort of support structure. You know, the ear is almost sort of mounted on a base of flesh that props it up and pushes it off the head, presumably, so that it can catch more sounds, you know. So you got to get this little bass back here. you don't want to go too far in terms of drawing a big thick line right there, but what I get some indication of this shading underneath it, and then maybe just a touch at the top. And, you know, depending on the hairstyle, the ear may well get concealed, but you do want to pay attention, you know, if you're comparing from one face to the other, that that these things fall in the same location from top to bottom. Well, it's time now to move on to drawing the kind of tricky, I would say less tricky than this, but kind of tricky contour that happens as someone is facing away from you. What I'm going to do is again, draw a diagonal line here that's going to help me in terms of placing some of these features. Okay, now this is a fairly subtle difference, but this triangle here is you know, considerably narrower at the base than this one is, and that's going to help you in terms of placing things. But the nose, the tip of the nose, to the degree to which it's visible, does fall in the same place, you know, same location here on this one line at the edge of the square. Now what I would like to do is, before I get on to drawing these contours, go ahead and do the chin heading back to the neck. All right, so a fairly similar pattern, although I think the distance here gets compressed a little as the face turns away. And then, you know, here we have this very sort of 90-degree looking angle. I would say this is slightly less than a 90-degree angle here, and that the chin, the line of the, or the chin, the line of the neck becomes a little more purely vertical at this stage. Now, if you want to, you can add a little extra line here that, even though we don't really see such a line in real life, that indicates some of the structure of the shoulder going up into the neck. Well, let's go ahead and maybe just all real time begin to deal with the fairly tricky contour of the face as it turns away from us. Now, what happens is that the mouth becomes almost invisible. I'm going to come down here and begin to curve around the chin. What happens is you get a little bit of a, it sort of puffs out, the flesh sort of puffs out a little bit, suggesting that the mouth is there, but it's just around the corner, basically. You don't really see the lips. And indeed, to the degree to which you happen to get an angle in which the lips are visible, it becomes increasingly challenging to draw it without it looking weird. So basically, I guess I'm taking the easy way out in today in terms of showing you a face that has turned to the degree that we don't even see the lips really, but we see, as I said, this sort of puff of flesh here. Puff of flesh. Maybe that's the name of Snake Belly's first album, Puff of Flesh. In stores now. But let's come down here and continue drawing up until we reach sort of the cheekbone. A little bit of a tie-in with last week's video. Of course, the we drew a skull, and you did indeed see the cheekbone quite a bit. But I'm leaving just a little bit of space here so as to get just the tip of the nose remaining visible. And now, as we said, this line here should be the eyelash line, and sometimes, depending on how, you know, just how the head is turned, you may see just a little indication of that eyelash. But basically what I do is I'm avoiding drawing much of an indication at all of the eye itself, and maybe just get a little hint of the edge of the eyebrow. And so as you can see, you're creating this very subtle line that suggests the presence of facial features without you actually drawing them. Now, what becomes very crucial when you're drawing the head at this angle is to get that shading underneath the chin and to sort of extend it up a little so that, you know, kind of as we did here, give it, maybe let it break a little bit and then have it connect back here at the base of the ear. And I think that getting that line in place is pretty important in terms of drawing the head at this angle. Maybe I'll just, instead of doing this all time lapse, I'll just give you a sense of where I would draw this particular hairstyle. And one thing that I like to do when I'm drawing a head at an angle here is to sort of imagine a line that goes up the back of the head, right? Because you're turned at a sort of a three-quarter angle as he turns away from you. I find that getting a line like this in place can help me in terms of drawing the rest of the hair and figuring that it sort of comes to a point, depending on what the barber did. Would you like it straight across the back or tapering to a point, sir? Tapering to a point, please. In any case, if you have this line in place, that'll help you to if you want to do a hairstyle like that. And I find it helps a lot, even in terms of adding the clothes, which I guess I'll do later on, sort of say he's wearing a t-shirt or whatever. But you can see back here behind the ear considerably more of the sort of contour of the haircut, I guess you could say. And then over here you're going to see a little less of that, of the sideburns area, but still you get some indication of this little thing that I was talking. Is there a word for this, people? Let me know. What is that thing called? That thing right there near that part of the head thing. And then, yeah, that basically, I don't think you need me to go through all of this real time, but that gives you some sense of where I would place this same hairstyle. So in time lapse, I'll go ahead and finish off the drawing of the hair. Okay, well, we've essentially got everything where we need it to be. I suppose the last thing I can do here is to show you just clothing, although that's not what this video is about, but if you were to add sort of an indication of the back of his t-shirt, you would, you know, if you've put in a line like that, that sort of helps you figure out the sort of lower edge of that curve, and then, you know, the rest of it hopefully just sort of going along and helping to suggest those contours. Over here, you know, I guess if this is the where it's coming down here, I would want to come over here and maybe have it rise up a little bit over his shoulder before coming back down again. Does that make sense?
I don't know, people. I'm just kind of winging it at this point.
So anyway, that pretty much takes us through to everything I wanted to cover in this video. I really wish I could, you know, make time for shading and so forth, but that would, again, make this video just ridiculously long. I think it's kind of ridiculously long as it is. So I'm going to pull out my trusty black Prismacolor. What pencil is that? People always ask. It is a black Prismacolor colored pencil. Really nothing fancy. If you can find an art supply store in your area, you can, you know, just get the best possible black colored pencil and you will have pretty much the same thing. Well, let's go ahead and all in time lapse, I'm going to go ahead and do all the final line work with the Prismacolor, add a little more shading, and then we'll be back with some final works. All right, well, there's my video on how to draw a man in profile and also as he is turning away from you. I do think that this is actually quite an important point of view to master as an illustrator, and it seems to me people don't teach it very often. So hopefully this will prove useful to you, and let me know if you would like me to do a similar video that covers females. Facial features in this same kind of a lesson. I did deliberately choose the male as the subject matter because people point out quite rightly that I tend to almost do female characters as a default, and I wanted to balance things out a little by way of this video. But for now, let me thank anyone who has supported me by getting any of my books like Miki Falls or Brody's Ghost, my two graphic novel series, as well as Mastering Manga and Mastering Manga to really do greatly appreciate the support of those of you who helped me out by getting those books. But let's go ahead and lay down this pencil. I want to thank you all for watching this video. I hope you found it useful, and I'll be back with another one real soon.